Hi everyone, I am Nirav. Welcome to SQL Server Always On Configuration video series. Earlier video, we have created a one resource group, Always On RG, one virtual network, Always On VNet, and availability set. Now in this video, we will create one domain controller server. Domain controller server is a centerpiece of the Windows Active Directory services. It authenticates a user, stores a user account information, and enforces the security policy for a Windows domain. So let's create one virtual machine and configure the Windows Active Directory services. So go to the virtual machine, click on Add button. Select a resource group always on RG. Give a meaningful name. So node DC, node domain controller. Select the region. I'm here selecting Southeast Asia. And selecting Windows Server 2012 R2 dataset. Give a username, admin DC. And password. Allow the port, RDP port, and click on next button. There is no change on the default setting. Go to the next. Select the NIC network security group none and click on next button. Boot diagnostics off. Go to the next. Go to the next. Next. And create. So deployment in progress. It will take 2 to 3 minutes. Yes. Now the deployment succeed. Go to the node DC. Click on connect button, download the RDP file. Now let's connect a virtual machine. So go to the server manager, then click on add and role feature. Go to the next button, select the role based or a feature based installation, click on next and select the Active Directory domain services, click on add feature and DNS server, click on next. There is no change on a default setting, click on next and click on install button. So configuration require installation succeed on a node DC. Additional steps are required to make this machine as a domain controller. So right now this machine is only a virtual machine, but we will make this machine as a domain controller. So click on close button and go to this warning notification and click on this button, promote this server to the domain controller. Select add new forest. And type the domain name. Click on next button. Type a username and password. Click on next. Click on next. Click on next. There is no change on a default setting. Next. Next. Click on install button. So SQL Brainbox is my domain name So after this installation complete, we will log in as a domain account. After the installation complete, it will require a restart. The computer is being restarted because Active Directory Domain Services was installed or removed. So machine got restart. Let's try to connect our Node.js machine using domain account. Click on connect and type your domain name first. So SQL Brainbox / admin DC is my username and type the password and click on OK. So now your machine is our domain controller. Let's quickly check. So go to the this PC property and see. Now the computer domain is sqlbrainbox.com and the computer name would be the node.dc.sqlbrainbox.com. Okay, so it means that we have successfully configured the domain services in this machine. Now let's enable the firewall. So right now I am configuring the inbound and outbound rules. In the company, these firewall rules are configured by the network team. So go to the new rule and I am allowing right now all the ports, all the program and all the connection. Now there is one more setting required in a domain controller. So go to the network, select the node DC, select the IP configurations, select the IP config and in private IP setting, just select the static IP and click on save. So this configuration is required. It will take a time. Copy this IP address. Now go to the virtual machine and just check our private IP address. The IP address is 10.10.10.4. This is a private IP address. Just copy it. Go to the networking. Click on network interface. Go to the DNS. By default, okay, just wait, please wait. Okay, go to the virtual network. Select the virtual network. Click on DNS server. By default, it is an Azure provider. Here we have to configure, click on custom and give our domain control IP address and save it. Restart the virtual machine again. So give a username and password. Check CMD, click on who am I, so here a SQL Brainbox is our domain name and admin DC is our username. So in this video we have successfully configured a domain controller. In the next video we will create a two virtual machine, SQL Node 1 and Node 2, and configure a failover cluster on that. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.